hospital.
Yeah,
that's
with
right.
Keith Allen, the biggest kid we know.
Yep.
He is, and this is brought to you by Turn Services. And Heath, where are you now? You know, last time I thought you were going to be at a party because they have a party there every afternoon.
Well, right now we are in an operating room here at Children's Hospital, and it's a very special operating room because here in the OR, you're looking at the Da Vinci surgery robot. It is the only Da Vinci surgery robot completely dedicated to operating on children in this area. And I'm telling you, this is it's like the future come home right now. This is Eden, by the way. She's our patient. Hi, Eden. How are you?
Good.
Good. I'll get back to you in just a second. Dr. Martin, if I get you to step over the wire and come here for just a minute, why don't you step over on this side? This is Dr. Aaron Martin. This is like the future come home, right?
It is. It's a very good tool for us to use to help kids in this region.
This is what makes this so amazing for children, and you can correct me anytime I'm wrong, is that it can go through such small incisions and do just really microscopic types of surgery.
Right, right. So a standard incision, if you look at Eden here, for a lot of the operations we do on the kidneys would be an incision about this long, from here to here. With this machine, I can make an incision just in the belly button, another one about the size of my pinky right here and right here, and do the same operation.
Now what happens is these little probes here, they kind of go into the arms, and that's what kind of goes, this big apparatus goes into those two tiny incisions.
Right, so this would hold the camera, which we don't have open right now, because it costs a lot of money to open and close these things. And then
I got my checkbook, you know.
I don't know if you have enough of this.
Okay.
And then these instruments, as you can see here, I don't know if you can zoom in on the tips here, are wristed, and so these wrists allow these to make these really small movements here, and open and close, as opposed to a standard laparoscopic instrument, which is stick figures.
So all of these various arms, and I don't know, can you see that, Dolly, if we hold it real still? Okay,
we're going to manually here.
Yes, they go into the tiny, tiny incisions. And those can actually move. They're more mobile than the human wrist.
Yes, yes.
I mean, they can actually do things that your hands couldn't do, you know,
right,
even if you could make it inside that little incision. Now, what makes this even cooler is this humongous apparatus is over here, and Eden's over here on the table, and the doc's over here. But if you turn around, the guy that's doing the surgery, Dr. Evans Valerie here, actually operates this machine from this console here. He's kind of like the pilot.
Absolutely. So the robot actually, the instruments that Dr. Martin showed you actually will respond to the motions that we do with these two sets of instruments.
And so what you can actually do, I mean, it's hard for us to see here because this is so complex, but you actually go right here. You can actually, there's a camera on the robotic part behind you, and you can actually just go ahead and put your face in there. You know what I mean?
These graspers control the instruments. This one down here controls the camera. And when we look in, the picture is actually in 3D and 10 times magnified.
3D, 10 times magnified. So you can actually do microscopic surgery, but it's like, it's easy to see and easier to handle.
Right, so for the children, when we want to do procedures that are more detailed and precise, the robot actually helps us with that.
Okay, I'm going to get Dolly to look back over here. Why don't you go ahead and move them around? Dolly, just kind of look at these arms over here. You can kind of see, because he can actually move those rascals.
So right, yeah, if these were in, we unfortunately don't have the ports hooked up at this time, but the arms would sit in here, and he would control that and
but
allow
you can control, you can move this whole
to move around any way it really wants to, while it obviously would be in Eden here, but we wouldn't do that while she's awake.
What kind of training does this take? This is a very specific kind of surgery.
Well, fortunately, I had the advantage of starting my residency training right when this robot had come out. So I've trained on it now. I'm going in my 10th year of using the robot, and so I've been very fortunate in that. But really, you can start this, just an experienced laparoscopic surgeon like Dr. Valerie here was able to go and take a training course that's provided by the company and learn pretty quickly to adapt your laparoscopic skills to use the robot itself. And that's one of the advantages of the robot, is how easy it is and adaptable it is to use.
You know, now the amazing thing, you said it was expensive just to turn the thing on.
Yeah.
What do you figure one of these things costs?
So a system like this costs around $2 million, and then it's about another $100,000 to $200,000 a year just for the maintenance contract. And then one of these instruments, which gets about 10 uses, is around $350. So every little piece adds up. And the important thing to know is the hospital doesn't receive any extra reimbursement for doing a procedure robotic versus doing it through the big open incision. And so the real reason to have this is because you care about your patients and you feel it's going to help them.
And we're talking a base of $2 million.
Yes, yes, it's not cheap.
Which is, again, why it's so important for people at home right now to go ahead and pick up the phone and make that call, make that donation, because this is the kind of apparatus that your donation will make. These are great for adults, but it's got to be so much more advantageous for a child to have something like this that can do that minuscule type of surgery.
Sure. The advantage for both adults and children, but especially children, is minimize the scarring, like we said, lower risk of blood transfusion, usually a shorter stay and less pain in the hospital. And so all of those things really add up, at least in our view, in the surgeon's view, and in many of our patients, if you talk to them, will agree. So this allows us to get to much smaller areas. Dr. Valerie is also using the new single port apparatus where you could do everything right through the belly button. No need to have any other incisions. And so that's really made a big advancement, and they're making advancements all the time in those tools where everyone can use it that way.
Okay, Eden, I am going to draw something on your belly button in a minute. So Dr. Valerie, how different is it, you know, from as a surgeon, from being able to use your hands to do the actual hands-on surgery to doing this type of robotic surgery?
Like Dr. Martin said, the robot actually mimics the movements of your hands, and so and there's actually more freedom of movement with the robot than you might have with your hand. It allows you to get into places that are usually difficult to get to with open surgery. I'm from general surgery, and the procedures that we do with the robot are robotic gallbladder removals. We do some anti-reflux operations, Nissen fundoplications. We do splenectomies when necessary in kids with sickle cell disease, just to name a few. But one of the real advantages of the robot for kids that we've found is that we're able to do the cholecystectomies, that is the removal of a gallbladder through a single incision in the belly button. And the robot actually, through a computer, allows us to use the instrument in a way that we're not able to laparoscopically. It actually uncrosses the instrument for us, and it makes it so much easier to do that particular procedure.
How difficult was it for you guys to acclimate yourselves to this type of surgery? You know, Dr. Martin would say, you can just go to a class. Well, you know, I flunked my driver's license test the first time. How difficult is this?
Well, Dr. Martin was lucky in that he learned to use a robot while he was in his residency. But I only learned to use a robot 2 years ago with a company in Atlanta. The name of the company is Intuitive, and I would say that learning to use the robot is actually intuitive. It allows you to, it really just mimics what your hands do, and it actually is easy.
It's easy. It's
relatively easy,
easy might not be the word that I would choose. It's kind of like, this is like the next step. There'll be a step after this.
Sure, sure. I mean, there's already more advanced robots than even this one that can track with the bed, goes through a single port, the arms are more flexible. And hopefully with time, this will get smaller. This is a large machine and get less expensive like all the other technologies out there. And that's the goal, is that we start with this and then we'll be well trained for the next model.
You know, you were talking about this being, there's new technology out there. This is still a really relatively young device. But in the world of technology, you know, 5-10 years goes by in a hurry, and there's something new out there.
Sure, yeah. In my 9 years of using it, this would be the third iteration of the system I've used. So, and it's gotten much smaller since the first one I used. So it's rapidly evolving.
And for children, we emphasize again, because this obviously is the Children's Miracle Network Telethon. This actually is so advantageous for a child like yours, like Eden here, who's serving as our patient and doesn't know I actually drew a skunk on her belly button, but don't tell her that. Anyway, for kids, this really is the kind of surgery that I don't know, it just fits them better.
Yeah, and families are so happy when you tell them, you know, I've operated as young as a 2-month-old with this robot, and they're so happy when you tell them you can go through a tiny little incision as opposed to scarring their their young little girl at 2 months old with an incision this big. It really makes a difference.
All right. Dr. Martin, Dr. Valerie, we appreciate the incredible surgeons in an incredible place, the OR here at Children's Hospital with the Da Vinci robot surgery device. Only $2 million. So if you really feel like it, you can go ahead and write that check, and they'll buy another one. I guarantee they'd love to have one more here at Children's Hospital. Guys, Eden, by the way, thank you very much for your fine work here. Oh.